This week at the Internet Cafe, the Webby Awards will take you to Bimbo's in San Francisco for the first annual Webbies, sponsored by the Web Magazine. Cintra Wilson, columnist for the online magazine Salon, is the mistress of ceremonies. We'll show you the Webby winners for best game site, best home education site, best money website, and best music site, plus Webby winners in 11 other categories, plus the People's Choice Awards and free software on our Cyber Blast. The first annual Webby Awards, next on the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is made possible in part by Intel. One innovative idea always leads to another. Now there are connected CD-ROMs that link rich multimedia with related information on the Internet. The connected CD-ROMs, it's the Intel Pentium processor.
Hi, and welcome to the Internet Cafe. I'm Stuart Chaffee. This is Jane Wither. And Andrew DeVries is not with us right now because he's off covering the Webby Awards. And that's what we're talking about tonight, the best of the web. The Web Magazine has put together the first annual Webbies to recognize the best 12 or 15 websites. I don't know how in the world you can do this.
Stuart, I was going to ask you that very question. I'm going, out of all of the thousands
of websites,
how on earth would you pick the best?
I don't know how they did. I was one of the judges for the finalists, but my job was very easy. They gave me five websites and said, somebody's figured out that these are the best of this category, and you look at them and you tell us which one you think is the best. But who found those five? I mean, who has the time to look at every single website?
Now, let me ask you, what kind of criteria did you use when you were judging?
Well, they didn't really establish any. What I used is, you know, kind of the graphic layout. Is it attractive? Is it easy to find the stuff you want? Is it fast? That's a big one for me. And is it well laid out? And it does really give me some useful information. The one I picked, by the way, I really loved, and we'll find out about, you know, who the winner was later. But right now, let's get to the Webby Awards. Andrew is there covering the Webbies at Bimbo's Nightclub in San Francisco.
I want to welcome all of you to Web Magazine's Webby Awards, first of its kind, I suspect anywhere in America. And that it's happening in San Francisco is just extraordinary. It's appropriate that it should happen in San Francisco. After all, we are the center of cyberspace. We are the cyber community of this country and this nation. The judges in 15 categories tonight will identify those individuals worthy of being acknowledged as the best in their business, the best in their area of interest, and the best at guiding us with their attractive designs, with their interest in logos, and with their cryptic information that leads us exactly where we need to go. On behalf of all of us who live and have the great privilege of living in this extraordinary city, welcome to Web Magazine's first ever Webby Awards. Thank you.
You're also known as a pretty big shopper. Have you ever done any shopping online?
No. I literally have touched the garment. I have tried on. And for me, clothing happens to be fit. And I've never been able to make that screen lay it on me the right way.
Catalog shopping and internet shopping are
not for me. Not for me, but for some people.
Right. It's a big
And tonight, when I was on stage, I said, and it was clear that some of you use the website to buy your wardrobe.
In each issue of the Web Magazine, they reviewed 500 different websites covering scads of different issues and interests. Everything from scientific sites such as acupuncture.com to, got some acupuncture fans, right? To political sites like the one put out by the California Voter Foundation, to such educational sites as Bianca's Smut Shack. Some 2,000 websites reviewed in the last four issues were divided into 15 different categories, and the editors named five nominees for each category. Okay, so tonight we have... Shut up! So, tonight we have two different groups of winners. We have winners selected by the People's Voice, which are the 40,000 people who voted online. And we have the winners who were selected by our amazing panel of around 80 impressive celebrity judges. I'd like to bring you the first of the categories. Books and magazines. The nominees are Feed, Salon, Suck, 24 Hours in Cyberspace, and Urban Desires. And the winner is... Salon!
So, Michael O'Donnell, you won for Best Magazine on the Web. Almost a little bit of an oxymoron, I think. But tell me a little bit about Salon, what it feels like to win this award.
It's a great feeling. The company's worked really hard over the last few years to make a magazine on the net readable and enjoyable and interactive, and it's really doing that. So it's a great recognition of all the hard work everyone's put in over the last 2 years.
Now, let me ask you a little question about magazines on the web. Obviously, at least I think the last time I looked at Salon, they weren't charging a subscription rate. How does that work for you guys, you know, and how do you see the future of magazines on the web going?
How do we pay the bills?
How do you pay the bills?
Well, you know, advertising is a big part of publishing. And like television, you know, if once the internet gets big enough, you can really pay for programming through advertising because the numbers are so high. But, you know, we're trying to keep Salon free to the public to access on the web. And, you know, advertising and other special values. And we're planning on introducing a print version of Salon in the coming months as well.
All right, next category. Film. And the nominees are Cinemedia Site, Mr. Showbiz, Internet Movie Database, Film.com, and E Online. And the winner is, for the film category, Internet Movie Database.
Internet Movie Database. I'm assuming it's a database of movies, right?
Yeah, basically, it's a database created by tens of thousands of users over the last 7 years. There's a team of about 16 editors who sort of manage the database. They're spread across three continents. And it's the most comprehensive database anywhere because it's built up from data contributed by film fans themselves.
So it's a personal thing for people. What basically would I, as a movie lover, be able to find on that site and do?
You could look up, you know, any movie that you were wondering about and read about who was in it, what the character names were. Read about any reviews that people wrote about it, read quotes from the dialogue. You could find other links to other resources on the net related to that movie.
So it's a real movie lover site. As far as search functions and things like that, how would I go in there? Can I just put the movie name in, or say I just know a character in a movie, could I find something that way?
We've got those searches. I guess we've got probably 20 different searches or so on the database. You can search by actor or actress, you can search by character name, movie title, you can search for words in movie quotes, you can search by word you can search by location that it was filmed in, the year it was released. You can view a list of the top 100 movies that the internet users themselves have voted on.
As well. So now Saturday night comes around and I want to go to a movie. Can I find reviews on the site as well?
Oh yeah, absolutely. We've got links to the rec.arts.movies.reviews archives. Link, you know, into each individual movie on the website.
Next category. Games. And the nominees are... You Don't Know Jack, the Macromedia Shockwave Gallery, Happy Puppy, GameSpot, and Games Domain. And the winner is... You Don't Know Jack!
This one's going to be Chip, Dances, Bugs, and Shrinks. And we will pay out $3,000 for this one. Okay, get your fingers ready. Let's get busy. Which means does not equal five.
Thanks to Julie, Leslie, and my son Ryan, go Berserk. The Jack team rules.
No, but you would think so with all the acne stuff he uses.
Next category. Home/education. And the nominees are Home Art, Cocktail, Family Planet, Britannica Online, and Toiletology 101. And the winner is... Family Planet!
Now tell me a little bit about your site. What is it all about?
Well, it's a site designed for thinking parents, and we've got everything from daily news on health and safety and, you know, product recalls. We've got parenting experts answering questions online. We have very active chat rooms on solving parenting issues like toilet training and, you name it.
So that's great, because I think one of the issues that's been going on recently is people sort of being afraid of the internet, you know, parents worrying about their kids getting on and seeing things they, you know, maybe shouldn't see. So this is actually a site that's sort of helping educate parents. Have you addressed that issue of
In fact, we have chat rooms for kids, and they're monitored daily. They're very active, very exciting. We hope to make the internet a safe place, not just for parents, but for kids, and to make parents feel like, hey, there's something here for me, there's something here for my family, I'm going to come back to this site.
Do you find that your readership is really looking for this kind of direction and, you know, where to go and where are the best sites?
Yeah, well, that's pretty much the number one thing they're doing. We have this tagline, which is what's on and where to go. So we're very much a guide to the internet. Well, obviously a lot of stuff about popular culture and really information of what's there. So we put this up on our site. We've been just getting tremendous response from people because they really want to look at the best sites.
Next category.
Money.
And the nominees are The Motley Fool, Fortune, CNNFN, Edmund's Automobile Guide, and Adbusters Culture Jammers Headquarters. And the winner is Edmund's Automobile Guide.
We're revolutionizing the way automobiles are being bought in America by just disseminating the information.
So I can go up on your site and find out how to buy a car, or actually buy a car?
You can go on our site, find out how to buy a car, find out what the dealers are paying for that car, and then make a purchase request for that car.
So I can actually get a price that's better than a dealer, or shop around and make sure I'm getting the best price?
We'll teach you how to make sure you know you're getting a good price.
Yeah, we tell you which is the best time of the month to buy.
Now, what if someone actually goes out and buys something based on what your site says? Turns out there was a better deal somewhere else. You guys offer any kind of guarantee or anything like that?
No, we teach the consumer how to make sure he's getting a good deal. We don't guarantee that they're going to use our information correctly. We've been a company around since 1966, pretty much doing this information in book form until about a couple years ago. We went online, starting on a Gopher site, and now on the World Wide Web.
Great. Well, my car is starting to get a little run down, so I'll have to go check it out. Thanks a lot.
Next category, music. And the nominees are Wilma, Addicted to Noise, Microsoft Music Central, check you out, Tunes.com, and SonicNet. And the winner is... SonicNet!
Well, we're really excited about the recent merger of Addicted to Noise and SonicNet. We're looking at this as a bridge between Multimedia Gulch and the Silicon Alley. And this is a joint effort here, and we're very proud of both of this, for both SonicNet and Addicted to Noise. Great. Now tell me what it is, though, SonicNet. When I go up there, what am I going to find?
Well, you're going to find music on the web, every sort of experience from chat to cybercast, which is live broadcast of concerts, to listening parties, which means you'll be able to listen to albums a certain time before they come out, before they're actually released, and before they're actually on the radio stations. All types of reviews, concert reviews. It's the music, the quintessential music experience on the web.
And us from Addicted to Noise bring all of the editorial.
That's right.
We're the place on the web for music news, album reviews, columns, features.
Next category, science. And the nominees are ArcNet, the Discovery Channel Online, the Exploratorium, Scientific American, and Smithsonian Magazine. And the winner is Exploratorium!
So
know, congratulations on this great award. You know, the Exploratorium was a place that I loved as a kid, and now you're bringing it to folks. How does it feel to win this award?
We're very honored to win it. We've been working it pretty hard since 1993 on our website, just adding to it continuously, and it's really nice to see the acknowledgement.
On this Cyber Blast, we're going to send you two software programs to help you get just what you want from the web. We'll be downloading nearly 4 megabytes of code in less than 120 seconds. You can actually see the data downloading right now. To get these files this fast through the TV signal, you need a card for your computer called a TV modem. We'll tell you more about that later. You can also download these files off the web using your regular telephone modem. Download time on the phone at 28.8 will be about a half an hour. Let me tell you what we're sending you. First of all, a demo version of a program called Freeloader version 2.5. What this program lets you do is select your favorite websites and automatically download a part of the site or all of the site onto your hard drive. Then you can surf the sites as much as you want offline. No waiting for lengthy real-time downloads. The second program we're sending you is called WebEx. It runs on Windows 95 and it lets you customize downloads off the internet or a corporate intranet. You can tell the program how deep you want to go into a website or how much disk space you want to allocate to that site, and then you can easily download just what you want. WebEx also features an integrated surf bar, which lets you do a download even while you're surfing another site. Remember, we're sending both programs to you right now through the television signal using our Cyber Blast technology. The speed of this download is equivalent to about 400 BPS modem using the broad bandwidth of the television signal. So it's a lot faster than using your usual telephone modem. If you need information on how to receive a Cyber Blast or on how to install a TV modem, just check out the Internet Cafe section of our website at pctv.com. You can also find information there on how to download these files directly from the net using a standard telephone modem. So the download is just about complete. Have fun with your new software. That wraps up this Cyber Blast on the Internet Cafe. I'm Laurie Anderson.
Next category. May I have complete silence?
Sex.
And the nominees are Bianca Smutcheck, The Safer Sex Pages, Persian Kitties Adult Links,
Spew,
and Adult Check.
And the winner is
Bianca Smutcheck!
Do you think this is going to mean more visitors into the Bianca Smutcheck?
I don't know how many more we can handle.
Yeah.
I think it's nice. I think it's like shows that our community works and people are really taking part in it and
yes,
everybody's happy with it.
Next category, sports. And the nominees are ESPN Net Sports Zone, Charged, The Coach's Edge, Instant Ballpark, and SkiNet. And the winner is ESPN Net Sports Zone, a Grand Slam winner. This site also won a People's Voice Award. A big, popular web favorite.
Okay, now I'm not a huge sports fan, but I do follow it from time to time. What am I going to find up on the ESPN Sports Zone?
Well, you're going to find scores, news, information, video clips, audio broadcasts of games, a lot of sports talent doing columns, and everything else.
Now, okay, the thing that comes to my mind is, though, TV is a pretty good medium for a lot of sports. What's different that you guys have?
Well, Sports Zone offers a sense of immediacy for events that aren't necessarily on TV informationally, so you have, like, a ton of information that's updating all the time.
No, so instantaneous game updates.
Exactly.
Now, actually, that brings up a point that I had read about recently where I think some of the folks, maybe it was the NFL, weren't so excited about having stuff broadcast live, saying it was proprietary, that they should be able to sell it. How have you got around that, or what's happening?
Well, there have been a couple of court rulings recently concerning real-time broadcast of game information, and it looks like the courts are actually coming down on the side of the media outlets in this case. Not that the leagues will be cut out of anything, but it will be considered a broadcast medium just like television, radio, and anything else.
Next category, travel. And the nominees are Travelocity, The Rough Guide USA, Travel Mag, Route 66, and Travlang. And the winner is Travel Mag. Come on down. Get your love.
All right. Jack, Jillian, Paul, and Paul, cheers.
I understand you guys are actually doing sort of a live broadcast of this show on the internet. What are you actually doing?
Well, basically what we're doing is we're capturing the audio and video in like the highest quality we can. Then we're feeding it into the encoders. So we have video encoders, we have audio encoders for real video, real audio. We also have photographers here, we have writers here, we have people who are interviewing people and putting these pieces together so people from 14.4 users on up to ISDN, T1, whatever, can get this information and have an experience.
Next category, TV. And the nominees are eDrive, PBS Online, The Gist, Ultimate TV, and The Biz. And the winner is The Gist!
The web is a little bit static and TV's somewhat dynamic, so tell me what the Gist does.
Well, The Gist is, you know, we tailor TV and online entertainment, or you can get listings of TV shows, your favorite types of TV shows, the Discovery Channel, the Nature Channel, things like that.
Now when you explain that to me, it sounds like, well, wait, why can't I just go out and buy TV Guide? What does your site offer that something like that wouldn't?
Because with TV Guide, you have to flip through all the other garbage to get to what you really want. And this way, you get what's really interesting to you right in front of your face.
So do I put in, like, key interests or things
exactly.
like...
Exactly. You type in the types of interests that are most important to you, and that's what you'll get back.
Weird. Next category is weird. And the nominees are Ad Nauseam, Gallery of the Absurd, Fetish, Entropy Gradient Reversals, and The Onion. And the winner is a Grand Slam winner. This site also won a People's Voice Award, Gallery of the Absurd!
So, Derek, you're from the Gallery of the Absurd, and I'm assuming you've won for most absurd website, or?
Well, the weirdest website.
Weirdest website.
Yes.
So tell me about it.
Basically, it's a repository, or a suppository, depending on how you look at it, of unusual signs, labels, and advertisements that are skewed in a particular way.
So you've basically satirized, logos and things that are popular?
Well, they satirize themselves. I add a few words that, but on their own, they could stand.
Okay, so give me an example of something
okay.
like that.
Okay, well, one is... a clown toilet brush, a ceramic clown toilet brush, which that in itself would be scary, but the fact that it is, the toilet brush holder is a clown sitting on a toilet with his pants down his legs is enough to make a grown man weep, so.
That is very scary. Now, you actually take pictures of these and put them up on the site?
I like to have the actual labels or advertisements themselves. If there's a sign somewhere, like at a department store with a weird name, or anything like that, then I like to have a picture taken of that because, you know, signs usually don't fit on scanners.
All right, there's only one more. Only one more. This is the top People's Voice Award voted in by the 40,000 online voters. This is the absolute top award of all the websites, all the people who voted online. And the top award for the People's Voice Awards goes to ESPN Net Sports Zone. So, thank you, and good night!
So, the man is back from the big party, and
yes,
tell us about the ambiance of the Webbies.
Well, it was a lot of fun. There was actually a lot more people there than I thought. It was invitation only, and it was kind of standing room only there, so it was a good crowd. I was hoping for celebrities. I like
you
celebrities.
Were there.
I was there, right? The you know, the mayor was
San
there,
Francisco.
Right? Few adult film actresses, and then sort of a bunch
that
of
that kind of event, huh?
And then a bunch of hanger-oners, yeah. But it was good.
What was it, like a serious, you know, Oscars type thing, or was it just a big party?
No, it was definitely more of a big party. I mean, it did have that you know, group of people getting up and accepting awards, but
yeah.
There was some, you know, really good bands, and it was just a fun
Sintra. How was
fun party.
Sintra?
Sintra was interesting. She was a little camera shy there.
Right.
We weren't able to get much of her, but it was a good episode.
Was there like a sort of consensus, you know, that the right people won? Because Jane and I at the beginning were talking about how in the world you pick the best website.
No, I think it was actually more of a free-for-all than anything else. I think there was a lot of people there that were disappointed and said, you know what,
I mean, boo and hiss.
My site was just as good as their site. Why didn't we win? What I found out was that The judges narrowed it down to 5 people in each category based on what the web magazine's reviewers had previously reviewed.
Okay, so it was the editorial staff of the magazine that said, hey, I've looked at these
right.
50 and here's five.
Right. And so, you know, again, it's still very much subjective to certain people's taste versus others. What was fun, our friends from Bianca Smutchak won Best Smut Award.
No, nah, that's not what I won.
And yes, it was. And they
best sexy website?
Best adult website.
Okay.
And mature. And they came in their famous bathrobes and corncob pipes and had a great time. So a lot of our friends were there from other shows, and so that was really nice to see that. You know,
well, maybe next year, Jane,
stuff.
You and I'll get to go to the wedding.
Anything's
huh?
possible.
Like I said, it's invite only, so I don't know.
Then we'll
all right, well, you got to see the Webbies. We'll see you here next week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is made possible in part by Intel. One innovative idea always leads to another. Now there are connected CD-ROMs that link rich multimedia with related information on the Internet. The connected CD-ROMs, it's the Intel Pentium processor. Videotapes of the Internet Cafe are available for $24.95 each. To order your copy, call 1-800-916-PCTV. We'll help you stay on top of the rapidly changing world of computers and personal technology. Call today for your copy of this episode of the Internet Cafe or any of our other award-winning programs. When ordering, please ask for tapes by show number and title. That's 1-800-916-PCTV.